tonight. From Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara, California. It's a special prime time edition of the NFL on EA Sports.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the so-called Silicon Valley and Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Tonight, we've got the crew set for what should be a real treat, a great Monday night matchup between the Los Angeles Rams and the San Francisco 49ers. And the opening kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. Former second round pick back in 2014, Jimmy Garoppolo trotting into place, looking to guide this San Francisco 49er offense.
And Jimmy Garoppolo has shown that he can be a Super Bowl quarterback, but his biggest problem, his ability to stay healthy and remain on the field. When able, he's a capable quarterback, prone to winning games both in the regular and postseason.
Pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes us forward for about six. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Now a play fake. Garoppolo. And the Rams got him. They bring him down. But just two plays in, and Charles already their first sack defensively.
Yeah, how about that? That didn't take long, did it? And now they look at third down, and that's another time to try and go and get the quarterback, too.
Here we go.
So the sack of Garoppolo, and now what can they come up with on third and long? Back to throw here. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Looks like a 9-yard loss, and it also brings up forward.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Here's Powell on the return. And just a net of 31 here, 40-yard punt, 9 on the return. And the Rams are going to start this drive in great field position as they take over. So now you've got their offense coming out for the first time with great initial field position. They'll be led out by a longtime starter in the NFL, a former number one overall pick way back in 2009. It's Matthew Stafford. Stafford on first down. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Nothing on that one, no gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down. Stafford. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
I think that's how this defense is going to need to play these tight ends. Again, get right up on them and stay physical. And that paid off on that play, helping force that incompletion.
Here's a run with Akers on second down. And down inside the 15 he goes. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone...
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart. And the 49ers are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
Back out there comes the 49ers offense ready for their second drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. There's Garoppolo to throw. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins the growing band of players. Just putting that stereotype right on its ear.
They fake the give, and then Garoppolo looks to throw.
To the defense. It is so nice. You're such an offensive guy like that. I love it. He dialed things up, and boy, a big play resulted for his guys.
Well, you like the credit to the defense there, right, my friend?
Yeah, do I ever.
Matt Gay on for the extra point. It's up, it's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for six. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield.
And the Rams got him. They bring him down. A'shaun Robinson. Give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards. Sacks now, they're starting to pile up, Charles, and that front seven defensively, they've had their way with this offensive line.
And I think at this stage, we have to start thinking about different play calls. We've got to start helping this quarterback out because the entire game, he's been under siege. I don't care what the down and distance, they've got to get the ball out of his hands a lot quicker.
Here we go. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that's dropped underneath to Mitchell. Oh, it shifts past him. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Well, they get 13, but it's not nearly enough. And it'll be fourth down. Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. 41-yard punt there with no return. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. So the Rams coming back onto the field, their second drive of the game. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot of points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? On second down, Akers into the 42-yard line here and brought down there.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
On first and 10, Stafford. Airing it out deep for Woods. And this is incomplete. Well played defensively. Nearly had the interception, but it's second down. On second down now, Akers, and he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. Throwing is Stafford. Looking underneath, he's got Akers. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game? That's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. And in this case, he picks up a first down.
And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. Well, that's always a good place to throw it just because he's one of the biggest targets, not only on this team, but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want them to catch the football first.
On second and 9, Stafford. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off at the 14. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now?
I would say so. And they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've got to be on the field a lot
position.
More than...
Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Joseph Day, the defensive tackle, getting in there for a loss of 5. He continues, Charles, to be under constant pressure, and these sacks, they're starting to pile up.
And if they want to have a realistic chance in this one, they've got to change their blocking assignments. They've got to do a better job to keep him upright. If he's going to be on the deck constantly, they've got no chance to win this game.
Third and long, it's Garoppolo. And that is incomplete. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zaps right back in the other direction. It'll be a net of 39, 41-yard punt, 2 on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48. They'll begin on the ground with Akers. Akers has got the first down and then some.
Round time, baby.
Touchdown, LA. Cam Akers, 52 yards. And the Rams strike quickly here for 6 points. Early on, they have all facets of the game working in tandem.
Yeah, you get the defensive touchdown early to give you the first score, and then your offense piggybacks on top of that and gets their own. And any coach we've ever talked to, and we've had that conversation with them prior to the game, they always say, you know, if we can score on defense or special teams, that gives us like a 95% chance of winning the game. I don't know if that number's correct, but it certainly does tend to play out that way, doesn't it?
It does.
Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the three and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go, because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off. On second and nine, Garoppolo, he's airing it out for Sanu, and that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Drops this underneath, it's Mitchell, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
Second and seven. On play action, now Garoppolo. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, this first half has not gone according to plan so far, offensively, or even defensively for that matter. They could use a big-time spark somewhere, but it's not going to come on this drive as they have to punt this one away.
Here comes the 49ers punter now as he's on to punt for the fourth time tonight. A 40-yard punt, 5 yards on the return, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. LA set to take over again on offense. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of...
On picked off by the former first rounder, Jimmy Ward. And the Niners are going to take over at their own 41. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Now a give, right side, Mitchell. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down. Garoppolo. Garoppolo. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And he gets it just shy of midfield, but that's not enough. He's short of the marker. They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down. Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Oh, the return is Powell. 35 yards that time on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And the Rams getting set to go now. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Back to throw. Stafford. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Stafford now to throw. And the coverage terrific there as that knocked down and incomplete.
That's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
Play action, Stafford. Again, he targets Kupp, and this time he's got it. And able to get this across the 45 before he's brought down. A couple of first downs on the drive already, as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Stafford going to give this to Akers. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 82 yards for him on the ground so far tonight, as he has been terrific in this first half. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line.
That's the third time on this drive these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going, and right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
They'll run on first down with Akers. Trey Greenlaw in there on the tackle.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third. Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. Stafford. Man open, it's Kupp, he's got it. And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I can't help but chuckle a little bit because at this point, it can't be a surprise to anyone in the building who's going to get the ball. They just keep feeding him over and over, and he just keeps on delivering.
They'll run on first down. Akers. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Cam Akers with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Rams add on to their lead. So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the second time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack. And you just have to love watching the way he can create space down near the goal line. And he's able to take it into the end zone.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 21 to 10. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. That's a dangerous territory right now. Three scores. Three and out here. And an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and you also have to guard against this. Every play. Pretty good shot downfield. You know, you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here. But you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
On first down, it's Mitchell. And given about five as he gets this up to the 48-yard line. The first down run got five. Here's second and five.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. There'll be a lot of chattering now because they seem to be moving the line of scrimmage.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Hands it off out of the gun. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on it.
Good game on that run. While this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about a different style of running in order to get this guy going.
Right back to Mitchell on second down.
Sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
On third down, it's Mitchell. Well, they hit the backfield and he wants to escape. And that is not going to get it done. A tough sled. Lose a yard there on third. And that one's not. The 55-yard attempt, normally you'd say, well, within his range. A little surprised he came up short.
And he knew it immediately, didn't he? They are so calibrated, aren't they? They can tell the touch, the feel. When they put the foot to the ball, whether it's going to be good or not, he knew immediately he didn't have that.
The hook up on the right side to Hopkins. Not much there, only a yard.
Partner took a while for him to lock onto a receiver, and he finally found his man coming left to right across the formation. But by the time he got the ball to him, not much of a chance to turn upfield and make anything out of it.
A yard in the wrong direction. It takes third down for a third down and nine.
That's what I see out of this defense. A little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them. They did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
Throwing on third down, Stafford. It's caught, Beckham. And they'll bring him down right at midfield, and he is well short of the first down. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. And this will hit just beyond the goal line. It's into the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the second quarter, but you're down.
You don't want to.
No, but.
Okay, my bad.
You're down three scores already. You've done nothing offensively, nothing on the scoreboard.
I think you just called a desperation time. I think you did. But let's face it, you mentioned this to me in a break earlier in the game. The energy level hasn't been there right from the start. We've noticed that. They've got to find a way to get on their toes and start punching instead of retreating, to use a boxing analogy.
The Niners on third down. It's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This is third and 10. It's caught. Mitchell. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. It's been a very one-sided game so far. They got to change what they're doing right now, don't they? You can't wait till the halftime speech to make an adjustment.
No, you can't, because if you're doing it right, you're adjusting from series to series, and they need a big...
And the Rams got it! They bring it down! Sebastian Joseph Day able to drop it that time for his second sack of of the evening.
Starting to wonder if this offensive line just simply doesn't like him. I mean, they've given up 6 sacks in this game. He's had nowhere to go, nowhere to run, and obviously nowhere to hide.
And all those sacks in the first half, this is just complete domination. They'll get 4 back there on the run, but now they're looking up at a 3rd-and-12 situation. Working from the gun, Garoppolo. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Mitchell. And he'll get this only to about the 38 as they stop him a few yards shy of the line to gain. Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he'll come on to kick for a 6th time tonight. This will be fielded at the 17. 8 yards on the return following a punt of 41. Set to go again. Here's Cam Akers in the LA offense. He's in his zone. 2nd quarter already closing in on a 100-yard game.
And that's the magic number for a running back. Anytime you get to that triple digits, that's all you're looking for. But he's got a chance to really exceed that in this one.
Yeah, he does. That's been the gold standard for a long time, hasn't it, that 100-yard mark?
It really has, and that never has to shift because it's in a game. It's a 1,000-yard mark. I'm wondering, since we've gone from 12 to 14 to 16 games, maybe we need to up that a little.
On first down, Stafford here. Open man right side is cut complete. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down.
Let's just call it what it is. This has been a flat-out struggle for this defense all game long. They've really had a hard time slowing them down. And while I'm not big on speeches and guys jumping up and down, they might need their team leader on defense to get in their face right now. Light a fire under these guys. Maybe I'll start playing better assignment football and start getting guys on the ground.
109 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the 2nd quarter.
On first down at Stafford. He'll dump this off to Akers. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup. Coming up on a 2nd-and-6. On the handoff, it's Akers. And he'll get 2 or 3 out of that one, as that is going to take us to the 2-minute warning. We remind you that coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will be alongside. He'll have highlights and analysis from Orlando of this first half of action. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Knocks this one through, and the round is on. It's 24-0. So everything else has gone right in this first half. Kind of follows that it would for their kicker, too, as he adds 3 more onto the lead.
Yeah, and the way that this one's gone, definitely not looking like he's going to have to worry too much about pressure kicks late in the game. He can go out there free and easy, just work on his form, and he knocked that one through.
Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. After the made field goal, Gay back out there to kick it off. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets the base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the side and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now for all the work he's getting.
And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. From the 45 on second down, Garoppolo caught by Sanu. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
Again, they'll throw with Garoppolo. To the right side, it's caught by Mitchell. Finding room to the 20. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. A big play there on the screen pass.
And that might be exactly what they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. Another try after the first down sack. Garoppolo looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And he's got it. They do get 8 out of the pitch and catch. However, it's fourth down.
That pattern and scheme was well defensed on third down. He tried to just sprint from one side of the field to the other, and they got it to him quickly. But no chance at yards after the catch there, and they stop him short.
The kick by Gold is good. And they get a little closer here as the lead's down to 3 touchdowns. So a long drive gets him down inside the 5, but ultimately they settle for just the field goal.
And I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the 3, and I think it was a smart move.
And he won't quite make it to the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything. Going up top for Kupp. And this is going to fall to the ground, incomplete. That very nearly their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
The final second ticks by, and that's going to do it for the first half of play. So we've come to halftime. The visiting Rams taking the lead to the break. As we'll send you eastward to Orlando, standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one is maybe not exactly in the bag yet, but there is definitely a big mountain to climb in this third quarter. The teams are already back out there, so let's not waste any time as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Going to get the football first here, and they look to build on their lead as the second half gets started. Oh, my goodness. I thought he'd peel off. Instead, he makes the fair catch at the 2-yard line. Here comes Matthew Stafford now to lead his offense back out there. And it was somewhat of a strange first half. He threw 3 interceptions, yet you look at the scoreboard, they've got the lead.
So you know what I think he did at the half? He stood up in front of the team, especially in front of the defense, and said, thank you. Appreciate what you've done. You guys picked me up in a big way. And guess what? I'm going to get back to being who I am, which is pretty darn good. Let's go play the second half.
Second down, they'll go with Akers again. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down. Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And he's able to get it out quickly, and this is not a bad kick here. 45 yards, that's what the punt goes for, 5 on the return. And the Niners set up well. They take over first and 10 on the short side of the field. Garoppolo now, first down throw. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Throwing now is Garoppolo. And looking for Kittle, but it's intercepted. Picked off by David Long.
Oh, yeah.
And he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown. So this defense doubling its pleasure there. Remember, they had the fumble return for a score earlier in the game, and now this time an interception return for another score. Extra point by Gay is up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 28. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So that didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
I see a shake of the head as he gets up, and you've got to imagine he's thinking, guys, you got to help me out. He's hoping his team can read his thoughts because...
Oh, into a seat. Defenders have intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. This defense, Charles, coming up with another interception. They have really done an excellent job of locking up these receivers.
Yeah, they're really on fire. They are actually doing what they talk about all the time, which is plastering to receivers when they're in their zones. They didn't give up a touchdown in the first half. Haven't done so here in this half either. Blanketed the field going all the way back to the opening drive, and they come up with a pick right there.
After the interception, here's Stafford. He'll get this one to Kupp, complete. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. They'll contain him to just 4, second down. Now it's Stafford. He finds Hopkins, complete. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. He needed 3, he got 2. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on 4th and a yard.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Gay's kick is good. And that will just add three more to a lead that's already out of hand. So tack on three more, though this, it's just a rare drive where they did not find the end zone.
Yeah, you're right about that, partner. But at this point, I don't think you're too concerned about that. You just want to possess the football for a while and drain the clock. If you can get three out of it, that's great, too.
And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guy. We'll get it at the 25. And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's got a man. It's his tight end. That's complete. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out.
There's a nice pickup right there. And after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
A leaping, and he makes the grab. Taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
Well, maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I'm wondering if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game, because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long, but a nice throw there for a good game and a first down.
That catch good for only a couple.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
And now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. Garoppolo now. Through the contact, it's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
Got his target, Samuel, and he's gonna get this inside the 30. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
And the last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. Samuel bringing in the slant. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 12-yard line. Now Garoppolo on the bootleg. Touchdown! It's complete. George Kittle from Jimmy Garoppolo. And a score closer.
As a general rule, quarterbacks don't want to lock in on a receiver before the ball is snapped. But in this case, based on the matchup he thought he was going to get, it was favorable for his tight end. He locked in on him early and found him for a touchdown.
Gold able to tack on the extra point, and the lead is down to 24. And the hands team for the Rams able to secure the football. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. On the give, this is Akers. Sheds off the tackle and brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. 129 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. Hit the lower center grab. gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Now Stafford. Well, that'll be caught by Kupp. Touchdown, Rams. Cooper Kupp, 30 yards. And the Rams are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Extra point by Gay is up and good, and that will extend this big lead. The long touchdown pass gets him 6 on a very, very tidy two-play drive that time. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. That ball caught, Brandon Ayuk. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, 49ers. Brandon Ayuk, 75 yards. And the 49ers make some inroads here on that deficit. Gold with the extra point. Drives you'll ever see. One play, 75 yards, 6 points. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. From the end zone, here comes Brandon Powell. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Cam Akers of the Rams offense ready to go back to work. He's already hit pay dirt twice. He's up over 100 yards. He is feeling good.
And he's just zipping along today. Everything coming together for him. It's that type of a day that you see him back. Just got to have a grin on his face every time his number is called. Because he doesn't feel like there are going to be any lost yardage plays. Nothing but big time positive runs.
Making the sideline grin as well. Now a deep ball going to be caught here near midfield.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
They'll run on first down. Akers. 138 yards rushing for him now as his big night continues.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Off of play action, here's Stafford. Being chased out left. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
On first down, Akers stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
On third down, here's a run by Akers.
Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. It's a pickup of four, but they're still a yard short here with fourth down forthcoming. And Gay knocks this one through. And that'll push the lead from 24 up to 27. I got to think at this point, third quarter, if you're able to hold on to the ball, get three at the end, that's all you're looking for.
I would agree with that because right now, this is a job well done by them. In fact, it's almost time for handshakes, a little dap on the sidelines, maybe even start to discuss post-game plans. And for the guys who haven't played yet, go ahead and get a look. Your time is now.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. That's the end of dust. Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Ahead of the chains now, second and two. On play action, it's Garoppolo. The same target, same result, it's Kittle. And he'll be taken down.
Good job there getting his tight end involved because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a first down.
Quick hitter here, it's complete.
think that throw kind of exemplifies what we've seen from this offense throughout this game. They've been in rhythm. They've been sharp. They've been high. And they pick up another first down there.
And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third. Three more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you could never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
And he'll just take a seat in the drive. We get a 25-yard line. San Francisco steps go on offense once more. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a field goal. They got 3 points on them. They got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's going to come out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense gets to 6 on the board. We'll see. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he goes out right around the 39.
Down. So now on defense, you assign a man.
On the intercept, Garoppolo for the third time. He's picked off at his own 46. And he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown. Defensively, they've got the way in this one. That pick six takes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what do you do when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You ready to go to the bench and hang out? He said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. I might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
Extra point. Shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And this will be a touchback, so they're going to be on to 25. San Francisco's offense returns to the field, and you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. Six. Six nine. And again, down to number 14.
as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them. Gets big yardage, puts points on the board.
Lance got him. They bring him down. Aaron Donnelly, his second sack of the night.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
Too great, and he goes down once more. Leonard Floyd, the old Georgia Bulldog, finding his way in the backfield.
And you could say that is just another cherry on top for this defense, that entire team. But really, this defense has sparked what's been an impressive effort here in this one.
I noticed you used the word sparked, because you're not seeing that on the other side of the ball. The offense right now, the spark has left their game, and it's been because of what you described, that defensive pressure.
Sacks. They were just trying to prevent another.
So what you're telling me is the conventional way has not really worked for them, huh?
Not at all.
So he tries to grab him here, and they still get caught.
Got him there. That's how you do. The 40. Past the 20. So the extra point good, and the roughing call going to move the ball out to the 50 for the kickoff.
And I think this is a big chance to penny deep if you can land the kickoff inside the 5-yard line or so. Gain some field position for your defense.
Get a look at this offense led by Cooper Kupp as they make their way back onto the field.
And I know that they've double teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. And what they're doing is 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
They'll fake it. Now Stafford. They'll let it go deep for Beckham. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Jason Brandt. And the 49ers are going to get the football here at their own 23. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. So after the INT, it's Garoppolo. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got to the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Looking to throw again on second down. Garoppolo. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. Game-changing play for this defense with the interception. At this point, though, I don't know that it's game-changing. I mean, they've got this one in firm control.
And you always hear about, you know, those stories about someone left their game plan behind and you benefit from it. I'm not going to say that that happened, but they certainly have appeared on defense to be a step ahead this entire game. Guys are always in the right spot in order to make a play.
The offense has had its moments, too. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. It's a jet sweep, the football to Woods. And he'll only get a yard to bring up third and one. And it appears we've got a member of the Rams shaking up on that last play. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. The offense on third down tonight, they've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. And he is going to have a Rams first down. At least it would appear that way. He didn't get it by much, but yes, they do get the conversion on third and one. And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 5.
Now a play fake and it's Stafford. And now here is another interception. Picked off inside the 5. And to the 12. That's where it stops. The return is halted at the 12-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start? And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Jalen Ramsey. And they will finally put it into the return, but not until he takes it back all the way inside the 10-yard line.
I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw his second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now 5 times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent. But a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ballgame, I would have said never. Not in a million years, but here we go. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Akers again. And he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. Akers is going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Everybody in the stadium knew what they were going to do right there, CD. 3 tight ends on the field, all that extra bulk, and they run it in.
And you saw where that one went, right? You run it over your best blocker. I can just see the head coach right now. I want to run this one over the big boy. And they got it done.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that will extend this big lead. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as they're driving again at the 25. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one play drive when you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action.
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and let him fling another one. Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there, it's going to artificially.
And now here is another interception. Picked off. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
CD, this defense, man, at this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
Solid running on the carry, but still brought down just inside the 40. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They'll go again here with Akers. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
On third down, Akers. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
Decision made for Sean McVay. They're going to go for it. Going with their tight end on 4. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29.
That was 4th and what we would call long in that situation, wasn't it? That wasn't 4th and inches, was it?
No, I mean, you get in those situations, 4th and 3, 4th and 4, that's a lot to, what would you say, a lot of pizza left in that box.
It certainly is. Not everyone dove in on that one. In today's NFL, this is a passing down, all right? This is not a running down. That takes a lot of guts to call that play and even better execution.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Going right back to Akers, and they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line.
But we always talk about good down and distance, allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
And they'll get him down right around the 16. Aziz Al-Shaair in to make the stop. Second and eight.
2 yards on the pickup. 54 and second and eight. That's a 16-yard line.
Watch the screen, watch the screen.
They'll try the air now with Stafford. Forced out to his left. And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. It's a loss of a yard, so they'll wind up crediting him with a sack, and it brings up third down. Now play number eight on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll only get this to the 14 as he'll come up well short of the first down. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. They've got a fourth down here in a game that looks to have been decided already. Gay's kick is good. And they're well on their way now as the lead grows even larger. So the turnover leads to points as they add three there.
Yeah, what a sequence there and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going
exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to. And my goodness, another interception. Jones hit, and the ball's out. And I think they are going to get this one back. Well, that would have been something. Double turnovers. But instead, they'll keep the possession on the INT.
All right, you've had to put up with me in this booth. I'm going to try.
And now, as with every potential turnover, we're going to take a second look at this. Just. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. And they take a knee. And they will take a knee here. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now, third and long. And they'll indeed take a knee. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. Teams meet, but until then, this game's over. But Charles, it's one thing to win, it's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
Thank you.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. With that, we say goodnight from Silicon Valley.